Models. So whenever you, so you say, well, what is a body? What is a body? And you say, well, the body is, right? When you predicate the body is, and then you subject, verb, predicate, right? When you predicate around that word is, you tell a story, right? It's a metaphor. So if I say the body is a machine, cool machine, but the mechanical model, right, the mechanistic model, body is machine, and I'm looking at an aggregate of parts that work together to accomplish things, and if it fails, it breaks, I can fix it, I can replace parts, add parts, improve parts, right? That's body is machine. It's a very useful model. We all are the beneficiaries of that model. Although sometimes we bump up against the model when someone who's using it in quite an attached way treats you more like a thing than as a conversation partner. I mean, do we really need to hear from the car? You know, right? Like, I'm changing your tire. Shut up. So this right model, the model can get in the way as well. Or for instance, my favorite is Saint Francis. Back 13th century monk guy. Do you remember St. Francis? You might know him today as the guy in your garden with the robes and the bald head and the bird on his shoulder. That's St. Francis, but he was really quite a complex and beautiful mystical figure in his day. And but he had, you know, he was a poet as well. He spoke of brother sun and sister moon, and when he referenced his body, he spoke of brother ass. Okay, so his metaphor for the body is a mule, a stubborn animal, right? That needs to be subjugated, right? Not listened to, but subjugated, right? That's a willful beast, right? That you need to sort of beat into submission so it will do your will as if it's in opposition to you, right? So your identity is not with the mule, but against it. Now, you can imagine how they treated a mule in the 13th century. That's exactly how Francis treated his body, right? He deprived it, he fasted, and he flagellated and beat himself for his whatever, his many wrongdoings that he imagined himself to be committing, and died at 42, right? At 42 years old, he was blind from fasting, and body beaten and broken, and he succumbed to his metaphor. And on his death, Matt, he laid himself out on the floor there. He apologized to Brother S for having taken it too far. I would have suggested, had I been there, Francis, you know, for any of us, what else could we consider? Maybe your body is a holy book. What if your body was a holy book, not a mule? What if it's a holy book? A scripture. The pages of your flesh are marked in exquisite detail with the finest hand, inscribed by spirit with the poetry of love, lessons of mercy, miracles, angelic hosts, and the story of your life perfectly told. An illuminated manuscript of sacred writing, epic in scope, majesty and grace. Every hair on your head and line on your face, every rushing tide of wind and wave moving you from within this living testament bear witness to the truth layered within you. Study this text with conviction, then reflect with care upon its meaning and enjoy the divine inspiration. See, models and metaphors, they matter. You're using them. Be mindful of the behaviors that are generated by your choices of how you model your body and your neighbor's body.